You can't get much more exotic than this, announced yesterday, the Aston Martin Lagonda, which comes complete with the ultimate mascot in sterling silver, would you believe? This is the long-awaited four-door Aston. It's a full four-seater with a top speed of 140 miles an hour. It was styled by the Cotswold-based designer, William Townes, who was also responsible for the Lagonda's sister car, the two-door Aston, still their mainstay. The Lagonda is powered by Aston's own 5.3-litre V8 engine. An automatic transmission is standard. Aston Martin is one specialist company which has been to the brink of extinction but came back again. 18 months ago, the receiver was in. Today, the order books are full and three-quarters of the output is being exported. This car won't be available till the spring, and then it will cost you £25,000. Well, that was to have been last spring, and for £25,000, now we're getting on for £33,000. It's taken Lagonda all that time to get it into production.
Plywood and glue, hardly the materials you'd expect for the creation of space-age technology. But here in Newport Pagnell, a couple of miles from Junction 14 on the M1, the Lagonda is built in a factory with a coach-building tradition that goes back, right back, to coaches, to the turn of the century, when they were still pulled by horses. Some of the crafts carry on. The new Lagonda will use 9 hides for the upholstery, with leather of this quality costing £1 a square foot. They'll use 1/3 of a hide just on the piping round the edge of the seats. You won't hear much about automation here. Each bonnet, each boot lid fits the car it was made for exactly. And they can tell here who's beaten each one into shape. They don't like rushing things. In fact, where the paint's concerned, the longer it takes, the better. The more time between each coat to let it harden, the better the finish will be. The engines are made by hand, fitted together, not just assembled. Big V8s and Aston Martin Lagonda is not the only maker's name on the cam covers. Every engine has its own builder's name here too. Alan Curtis is a shareholder, the managing director, and one of the men responsible for the dramatic rescue of Aston Martin Lagonda from receivership in 1975. Mr. Curtis, on your original estimates, the car is more than a year late and it costs 50% up on what you first estimated. Most businessmen would regard that as a major miscalculation. How do you regard it?
I regard it as most businessmen would regard it, a major miscalculation. That's exactly right.
But
regrettably.
What went wrong? What, did you hit some major snag?
No, I think we were perhaps overconfident at Earl's Court. We were carried away with the beauty of the car and the occasion and the massive interest shown on in the whole thing by everybody. And we allowed ourselves to be misled by the circumstances. But came the cold, hard light of day when we reassessed the situation and realised that there was no way we were going to produce this motor car in the timescale we thought, or within the costings that we had originally conceived. And hence we had to confess it publicly last year.
Now, I know you've had orders on your books for at least 18 months. Have people actually pulled out of those orders because of the price increase, because of the delay?
Yes, I think we've lost 9 customers, but we've gained somewhere around about 31 at the same time.
Now, are you absolutely confident that a motor car selling at £33,000 will really sell in the 1980s?
Oh, yes, I am. I'm very confident that this motor car will sell. I think the car that we've put together, engineered, is a beautiful motor car to drive. It sits well on the road. Its appearance will take it well into the 1980s. Its content will take it well into the 1980s. I think there are sufficient numbers of people around the world who appreciate a beautiful motor car built by hand, almost as an exclusive item in their collection. Those sort of people will go on buying this sort of motor car. And I've no doubt at all that we will be still building and selling it in 1985 very satisfactorily.
They may appreciate it, but how long will they have to wait for it?
If you ordered a car today, you would have to wait 2 years, 3 months.
So how many cars do you build a week? It can't be very many.
At the moment, we build in total 6 cars a week. At the end of this year, we will be building 4 of the 2-doors and 2 Lagondas a week. Next year, 2, possibly 3 Lagondas a week. But we can't shut down on the 2-door production because that is selling so very well. The order book for that is well into next year.
Now, perhaps the most impressive part of the car is inside, the gadgetry. It's a very complicated car. If things go wrong with that car when it's been delivered to its owner, who's going to put it right?
We have a number of service dealers already established, both here in the United States, on the continent, and in the Middle East. And they're being trained now in the servicing of this motor car and in the servicing of the electronics. The electronics, in fact, will not be a difficult thing to service. They will, in fact, be easier than manually operated motor cars, we believe. And as to its general reliability and servicing content, bear in mind what's happened in the field of aviation. As I said earlier, I'm going today to Norwich in a light aircraft, and when I take off from Cranfield, I should press a button and the airplane will do the rest for me. That's been happening in the fields of aviation for years. It's about time we were able to do something of that sort in the motor car business.